mobile phone, smartphones are integral part of our life, right? Over 80% of the adult population in the United States have a smartphone. With the new iPhone Face ID, the technology has improved sufficiently and made it very strong, both for authentication as well as for spoof resistance.
Different people have slightly different arrangement of the, you know, eye-to-eye distance, eye-to-mouth distance, nose-to-eye distance, so on and so forth. So the shape information can be utilized to do the recognition. The second type of difference, of course, is the texture, right? So we have, you know, slightly different skin textures. Those can also be used for doing face recognition. So in order to handle this kind of different face matching view angles, during the enrollment, when you capture faces, you wish to capture face from all different view angles. Therefore, during the enrollment, you know, Apple will ask you to face the camera, rotate your face left, right, up, down, right? So that eventually, it can capture face from left ear to the right ear, all the way in front of the forehead, including the neck part. Even though part of the face, such as the mouth, such as forehead, have been occulted, there's still a good chance that the visible part will be able to recognize the faces. So if even you have lots of beards, the 3D sensor can see through the facial hair, essentially get to your skin to estimate the shape. When you use infrared sensors, you could live with low light environment. You know, in the dark, in the low light, infrared can still capture data, so you can still do face recognition. I think that's very important for iPhone because people use the phone in all different kinds of lighting conditions. Well, if you use 3D sensors, the problem will be less because 3D sensors only cares about the shape information, don't care about the photometric property on faces. So I think in the long run, many of those attacks could be reliably detected, hence your phone will still be safe.
Now at some later point, there is no reason why we cannot have both Touch ID as well as Face ID in a mobile phone. In fact, that's a very strong possibility. In fact, there may be even iris recognition in there. So this is called multi-biometrics.